The all-new Hue 2 lighting system from NZXT brings even more possibilities to your setup. With addressable RGB underglow, cable combs, and monitor lighting with a unique ambient mode that pulls colors from your primary display to create a one-of-a-kind gaming experience. Check out everything Hue 2 has to offer in the link below. All right, y'all. So we're back again, and I have Chris here in the studio. You guys know Chris. He helps us out with camera stuff and editing once in a while. Yes. And today we are building a system for him. Now, you've actually built some rigs in the past, but this will be the first one that you're actually assembling for yourself, correct?
Yes.
Why exactly do you need a PC right now? What is this for?
Well, I'm going to be editing a lot of stuff. I have obviously a lot of projects going on that I work on myself, that I'll edit, that I'll color. I usually go through a lot of the Adobe products that are very, hardware intensive, can be a bit crippling to try and navigate through the programs without having a good PC. And my iMac right now, the iMac's just not cutting it right now. So I figured, what the heck?
It's also kind of confusing to me because traditionally I've known you as an Apple user. You know, you have an iMac, you've had a MacBook Pros and things like that in the past. So why the sudden switch over to PC?
Well, simply put, Kyle, I'd be spending twice the amount on a Apple product and be getting less than half of the performance. Simple as that.
I have no further questions, Your Honor. That's a damn good reason if I've ever heard one, and it makes a lot of sense. Additionally, you'll be able to upgrade and sort of maintain your system a bit more readily than you could with a product that's sold by a
also
company
true.
That believes in a closed ecosystem. But we're not here to talk about that. Let's discuss a little bit more about your rig here. So we actually have a pretty nice all-star lineup of hardware, starting with the CPU. This is actually one that I have donated from the Bitwit bin. It's a 7900X Core i9 Skylake X processor from good old Intel. It's got 10 cores, 20 threads. It's a total beast, and I'm sure a lot of the applications that you're using are multi-threaded in nature. It's good that since you'll be using a lot of software that can actually leverage those additional cores and threads, that we're packing in quite a number of cores and threads here. That'll be really nice. It's going to be slotting into, what is this board that we
this
have here?
This is the X299M Gaming Pro Carbon AC from MSI. I really didn't want to go with a large full tower case, which is kind of why we're going micro ATX today.
Are we favoring a smaller system this time around because it's going to be mobile some of the time?
It's going to be portable. It's going to be mobile.
Gotcha.
I sometimes have some jobs where I have to take my PC on the road with me, or just in general, like if I'm going to go edit somewhere far away from home, then it's got to be somewhat portable, easier to handle and all that jazz.
Makes sense. And this is actually just a beautiful board in general, as is. Apart from the form factor, you're getting, of course, the LGA 2066 socket with quad channel memory support, which we will be taking full advantage of, as well as M.2 support with NVMe drives and things like that, USB 3.1 Gen 2 Type-C, and the list goes on. So thank you to MSI for providing that.
Yes.
We also have a killer memory kit here. We actually have 32 gigs of G-Skills Trident Z RGB DDR4 at 3200 speed. So we've got fast memory. I believe it's a cast latency 16, so that's also pretty sweet. And you might notice that we actually have two kits there instead of one 32 gig kit. And that was because you had better deals on buying the kits individually during Black Friday, correct?
There were better deals.
Than buying a whole kit, which is fine. As long as they're the same spec and things like that, they should be working just fine together.
Mm-hmm.
If not, you know who to call.
Ghostbusters.
G-Skill.
Oh.
Definitely not me.
Or
Ghostbusters, as long as it's not me. That's fine. Moving on, though, we've got a pretty nice storage solution here, too, Chris. These were picked out by you as well. Tell us
Indeed.
About these and your rationale behind them.
Well, I figured once you go black, you can never go any other direction.
Blue.
So,
yep.
Or blue. I picked up the 500 gig M.2 NVMe Western Digital Black.
This is a great drive.
Because, again, sales. And moving on to the mechanical storage, I ended up going with 2 1-terabyte drives. The rationale behind this was essentially I could go for a 2-terabyte drive, but I simply wanted to RAID 0 them, and I would get better prices anyways on the 1-terabytes that were already available on Black Friday, so, kind of better bang for buck with a little bit better performance than a simple 2-terabyte.
Yep, absolutely. So by striping them, you get essentially, relatively double your bandwidth there, your transfer speeds, and you'll be backing things up externally, I'm sure. So
every project we're already backing up everything, so that's
that'll sort of alleviate some of the risk factor of running RAID 0. Additionally, we have a lovely cooler here. This is the H110i from Corsair, 280 millimeter liquid AIO. It's got a very solid copper plate as well, so that should be doing a fine number on our 7900X there. We also have a killer graphics card. This is the Duke RTX 2070 from MSI, excuse me. This is a touring card that is also gonna be so good for all of your workstation applications, as well as any gaming if you were to dabble in that. Let's be honest, are you gonna game with this system at all? Because I feel like it'd be a slight shame not to, given the product stack here.
I think I'm gonna have to slip and say yes.
Okay.
There's gonna be some heavy gaming.
It's not slipping, that's just, you're just being honest. There's nothing, no shame in that. And I think you mention to me earlier that you may be interested in trying out some VR.
VR indeed.
Absolutely.
You know, I think it's going to be a really great tool for pre-production and you know, a lot of pre-viz. A lot of directors can see kind of what these CG worlds are going to be like. So I think that's going to be a huge step in filmmaking, and I kind of want to get on the forefront of that.
Absolutely.
Kind of dabbling in that.
Absolutely. And it's also great that these touring cards now have Virtual Link built into the back. So you've got that Type-C connector for next generation of HMDs or headsets. You'll just be able to plug it in with a single connector. That's super sweet. And then we've got a pretty nice power supply over there. Chris, why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Indeed we do. It's the ROG Thor 850 Watt Platinum. It is Platinum certified?
Yes, 80 plus platinum.
80 plus platinum.
It would be a crime to be anything less.
It would indeed.
With a name like that.
850 watt, you know, gold certified doesn't sit well.
No.
No, with the platinum. But it's got a nice OLED screen telling you what your power draw is.
That is actually kind of nifty.
Yeah, it looks like it's going to be a gorgeous screen. And we got some nice sleeve cables that also come with it. The 24 pin, the two 6 plus 2 pins, the two 8 pins are all come sleeve.
You know what I'm actually kind of curious though, is if the OLED, how visible the OLED screen is going to be underneath the power supply shroud of our case, which you guys have probably noticed isn't even on the table right now because it gets its own special independent B-roll because it's fancy.
Because we couldn't fit it on this.
Not because we couldn't fit it on the table at all.
Not at all.
Is that definitely not. This is the Fantex Enthu Evolve Micro ATX case, which is one of the better looking Micro ATX cases in existence, IMO. Chris seems to agree because he actually picked it out himself. And we were initially going to go with an Evolve X, the newer case from Fantex, but it's full ATX. It's a pretty big mid-tower, and we wanted to keep things a little bit more mobile. So that's why we're going the Micro ATX route.
Size did not matter in this build.
No, absolutely not. What Wifey Sauce tells me every night. Did I say that out loud? Anyway, thank you guys for staying tuned for the build. That's what's coming up next. You can find links to all this stuff in the description below. But without further ado, I'm gonna make you build the system. We're gonna do a role reversal. I'm gonna man the camera, you build the system. Is that dangerous? Is that okay? Can we do that?
I don't like the sound of that, but sure. Let's do a role reversal.
Screw it. Building pun. And here she is, build complete. Man, oh man, look at that, it looks really nice.
That's gorgeous.
I really like the style that you went with, Chris. I'm digging the sort of color neutral vibe. It's not completely littered with RGB. In fact, why don't we turn it on? Should we turn it on?
Shall you do the honors?
No, you have to do the honors. It's your build. You built it, it's
already
your
bit
system.
Me once. This case here, right here, attacked me. I don't know how, but apparently it just gave me a huge gash on my finger, so.
Very sharp edges
Bad
around
case.
This case. But hey, you know what? You made a blood sacrifice to the PC gods, and because of that, this is now a holy blessed rig. And it will serve you well for years to come. That's what that means. So, all right, let's go ahead and power it on.
With the blood finger.
With the blood finger. No better way. Oh, Jesus.
Fan blade is hitting something.
Oh.
Oh, I know what it is.
I think our graphics card cables were hitting the fan.
It's the zip tie on the cables.
But it seems like he just had to move it out of the way.
And I think that's why, at higher speeds, it went away.
Okay.
Because the graphics card is actually not on.
Right.
So it's a non-issue.
Okay, cool. But the system is powered on and it's booted. Just says, you know, insert boot media and select the boot device.
Hey,
press any key and all that. So, hey, we have cleared post. You also might notice that there are some new additions to this case that we didn't mention in the beginning of the video. For starters, the Halos Lux RGB fan frames, which are also from Fantex. We actually threw those in there last minute just to give the system more of a bling factor. And of course, since they are from Fantex in the same anthracite gray that the case is in, they match
it's
beautiful. And then we also have, at the front of the case, we installed two Corsair ML140 Pro maglev fans. These are some of the best in the industry. We felt in a relatively air-constrictive case, especially at the front panel, that really good intake fans were necessary.
Yeah, so, I can feel it. It's like, like all around. Like,
so I mean, yeah, there's a ton of air going through here.
And we've got 1, 2, 3, 4,
so 5 140 millimeter fans in this system. Wow. It is audible for sure. Granted, we don't have the side panel on, but it is audible. I'm sure it'd be a bit quieter with the side panel on, and you can even configure those fans in the future, Chris, if you'd like to bring down the acoustics a smidge. Even though this is a beautiful build, of course, you're gonna go in and adjust all the RGB as you see fit later on. Doesn't mean we were without any snacks. There were a couple moments, if you will. I think the first one was the clearance actually between this rear included fan, the 140, and the actual IO cover of the motherboard. It's a combination of this being a relatively narrow case, this being a large fan, and that IO shield just being a little bit on the high side. They're definitely pushing against each other quite a bit.
Making contact.
Yeah. We could have avoided it easily altogether if we just downgraded to a 120 millimeter fan at the back, but who wants to do that? We also had somewhat of a close call with the front fans and the AIO tubes.
Oh yeah.
There was a bit of a clearance issue there, but we simply just slid the fans down.
Mm-hmm.
Not a big deal. How about that power supply? Look at that PSU.
Wow. I know.
That OLED screen is sexy AF.
Really smexy.
My goodness. Plus there's Aura Sync RGB down there that you can configure to your heart's content. You want to talk about some of the cable management, Christopher?
Well, you know, you have all these components and whatnot. Cable management can get a little rough with all the RGB and all the fans that we have in this case.
True.
It was a little difficult. We had to make sure that all the cables were really hugging that motherboard, but I think we got it for the most part successfully in there, and it's pretty flush.
It also doesn't help us any that the side panel on the back is magnetic only, so there's no actual physical screws, which that's definitely true. Means you gotta be hugging that tray pretty closely. But for the most part, everything looks and is functioning properly. We're ready for Windows 10 installation, and you can officially take your new system home starting today, Chris. So congratulations on your first PC for yourself.
Thank you.
You've also assembled yourself.
Thank you.
And I hope it serves you well for many years.
It's my new baby.
I know. But that's going to do it for now, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in. Be sure to send your congratulations Chris's way either in the comments or on social media. Be sure to toss a like on this video if you enjoyed it, because it was a damn good video. And you should also get subscribed to the channel for more tech stuff coming at you really soon. But till next time, guys, thanks again for watching. Have a good one, and we'll see you in the next video. What he said. Either way.
It works on.
It's his channel now.
It's yours. It's actually PJ's.
No, I don't care.
Okay. All right.
It's fine. You can have it.